Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. I'm Natalie, and today we are watching The Shawshank Redemption. Welcome back to my channel, everyone. Thank you so much for being here, and welcome if you're new. Today, we're diving into something different yet again, and that's The Shawshank Redemption. Once again, I am showing that I really just cannot decide to stick with genre. We've recently done Kung Fu Panda, Harry Potter, and today we're doing The Shawshank Redemption. I actually have seen this movie before, but it was so long ago that I don't really remember what happens in it. I watched it back when I was a freshman in high school because I had really cool English teachers who, along with required reading, also had required movies to watch. So I remember The Usual Suspects was another movie that I was required to watch. And that one, I very much remember. That one was unforgettable plot-wise in my mind. It just was burned into my brain. And I think Pulp Fiction, weirdly enough, was also required viewing. Probably not when I was a freshman, probably when I was a senior. I don't know why it was required viewing, but I'm really happy looking back on it that it was. And I think The Breakfast Club, weirdly enough, as well. I just had really cool English teachers who just wanted us to watch awesome movies in freshman and senior year of high school, particularly, I remember. So this was one of those movies that was required viewing for me. And because it was so long ago, I really don't remember much of it at all. So I'm really excited to dive into it again. I see it's also directed by Frank Darabont. And a lot of you guys have also been suggesting The Green Mile for me to watch. And I think I'm going to do a poll on Patreon very soon with solely Tom Hanks movies. And I'll probably include The Green Mile in that poll. So I have a feeling that one will win because that one's been suggested a lot. And probably by the same people who've been suggesting The Shawshank Redemption. It's all starting to make sense now. For those of you watching on YouTube, if you didn't know, I do have a Patreon page. I always link that in the description bar below. That's where you can catch my full-length reactions to everything we watch over here. They're just posted in a watch-along style format, so you do need your own copy to watch along with me. And you can also vote in polls and help me decide what I watch next. But by the time you're seeing this video, I probably will have already done the Tom Hanks poll. I will admit that I am super far ahead on Patreon videos and a little bit more behind on YouTube. So if you also like having earlier access to the content, that might be a reason for you to check it out as well, but no worries if that's not something you're interested in. But with all that being said, guys, I am ready to just hop on into this movie. I'm really excited to revisit this one. I just have a feeling it'll be a really fun viewing experience because I just remember this movie being really moving and really well done, but I could not tell you what the plot is. So I'm excited to watch this as more of an adult with a wider array of films under my belt. So if you're ready, I think we should just grab a drink, grab a snack, and let's get into the movie.
More than words can say.
I already love the score. Also, this may be a dumb question, but was this written by Stephen King? Oh no, is he gonna pull out a gun? He's got this sad look in his eyes, like he's gonna kill himself. It's a gun. All right. Oh no. He's got alcohol. Yeah, he had the look of despair in his eyes.
Mr. Dufresne, describe the confrontation you had with your wife the night that she was murdered.
She wanted a divorce in Reno.
I'll see you in hell before I see you in Reno. Those were the words you used, Mr. Dufresne.
What a theatrical quote. Oh, maybe this guy murders them and he's not gonna kill himself, he's gonna kill them.
I find it decidedly inconvenient that the gun was never found.
This guy, if he didn't commit the crime, he really is acting like a psychopath. Like, you should blink more, dude. It would maybe help the jury think you're innocent, but I think he did it.
But was their crime so great as to merit a death sentence?
Oh, you're leaving me in suspense. Did he do it or not? I mean, it's gotta be him. Who else would it be?
By the power vested in me by the state of Maine.
Maine.
I hereby order you to serve 2 life sentences back to back.
Oh boy. Now he's finally reacting. I forget why the movie is called Shawshank Redemption. Like, maybe Shawshank is the name of the prison. Is it Morgan? Morgan! He had to wear jeans at this jail?
No longer danger to society. That's God's honest truth.
Rejected. Oh.
There must be a con like me in every prison in America.
Ugh. I love Morgan Freeman's narration. Whoa, I gotta say, I know it's a prison, but this building is beautiful. Did they actually film this in Maine, or was this filmed somewhere else? I'm gonna have to look that up.
Andy came to Shawshank Prison in early 19...
Shawshank. I don't know what I'm trying to do. Yeah, this is kind of intense. Like, you don't bring people in secretly. You gotta bring them in, and it's like a whole show. You wouldn't put all the prisoners inside to bring people in.
You speak English, butt steak.
Butt steak? What kind of insult is that?
All prisoners, return to your cell blocks.
Yeah, it seems like we should have had everybody return to their cell blocks before bringing these people in. It's time for processing.
It's Mr. Hadley. He's captain of the guards. I'm Mr. Norton, the warden. You are convicted felons.
Thanks for the introduction, dude.
Rule number one, I'll not have the Lord's name taken in vain in my prison.
I wouldn't do well in this prison.
I believe in two things, discipline and the Bible.
Oh, goody. Can I go to a Jewish prison?
Delousing.
Oh, delousing. Oh, fun. You know, I actually got lice one time at summer camp because a girl showed up to camp with lice, and it was a theater camp, so we all got lice. I didn't really get it bad. I didn't have to cut off my hair or anything. I just had to do the shampoo thing. But they really should have deloused us when we showed up at summer camp.
The boys always go fishing with first-timers, and they don't quit till they reel someone in.
Oh, that's why someone goes crazy, huh?
Please, man, please, what a mistake!
Oh, no. You're gonna get beat, dude.
Open that cell!
Oh, no, dude. Oh, no. This captain is not okay. This is so messed up. Stop, you're gonna kill him. I mean, I know that, like, this is how a lot of cops were and still are, but especially back in, like, I don't know what year this is, but especially back in the day. Oh, is there something in it? Oh. Is it a maggot? That's a worm. Oh.
Are you going to eat that?
What, you want it? What? Oh, he's got a bird. Oh my God, thank God. I was so concerned that this man was about to eat a worm.
How's that horse of mine doing anyway?
Dead? Hadley busted his head up pretty good.
He died. Jesus Christ. That's awful.
Hey, we all need friends in here. I could be a friend to you.
I have never heard anyone say, I could be a friend to you in such an intimidating
I like that.
Way. Oh no, he likes that he's hard to get. Ah! That's intimidating as hell.
Wasn't until a month went by that he finally opened his mouth to say more than two words to somebody. That somebody was me.
Of course it was. You're the narrator, Morgan.
Why'd you do it?
I didn't, since you ask.
Everybody in here is innocent. Didn't you know that?
Maybe he really didn't do it. We didn't see, so I don't know still.
I wonder if you might get me a rock hammer.
What is it and why?
What do you care?
Ooh.
Well, if it was a toothbrush, I wouldn't ask questions. I'd just quote a price. But then a toothbrush is a non-lethal object, isn't it?
That's true. And also, do they not have toothbrushes? They should definitely have toothbrushes. That's problematic.
It's making it even $10.
You know what's so funny? He got rejected for getting let out. But if they let him out, they lose their guy that gets contraband and stuff into the prison all the time. It'd be better for the prison to just let him go.
Name's Red.
Red. Why do they call you that?
Maybe it's because I'm Irish.
I think it would be fair to say I liked Andy from the start.
Aww. And a beautiful friendship has begun. Oh, it's this guy with the bird. Oh, he's gonna use it to pass. I like how he just takes the book without even looking at what the title is. I wonder what he is gonna use the rock hammer for if he wouldn't be able to use it to escape. Oh no, I'm nervous. I'm scared right now. Oh, yep, I knew it. I knew he was coming. Oh boy, here they are. Lovely.
You fight. Better that way.
Poor Andy.
It was outdoor detail.
You need to be outside. Of course, everybody wants that job.
Move.
Did he just pay off a guard? I feel like that wouldn't work.
Me and some fellows I know were among the names called.
Oh, because he paid him a.
Only cost us a pack of smokes per man.
Oh. Man, even the guards get paid off for smokes? This is crazy.
So anyway, this lawyer fella says to me, your brother died a rich man.
$35,000. That's what he left me.
Dumb s***. What do you think the government's gonna do to me?
Yeah, this guy's a pessimist. You can't be an optimist around him.
Keep your eyes on your mop, man. Andy.
Thank you, Red. Talking some sense into Andy. Staring a little too long. Gosh. Andy, stop looking! Oh no, is he gonna give him advice? Maybe he's gonna give him advice. Oh, Red is like, Andy's gonna die, Andy's gonna die.
Do you trust your wife?
Because if you do trust her, there's no reason you can't keep that $35,000!
Oh, Jesus. He really is putting his life on the line for this prick.
I'd only ask 3 beers apiece for each of my co-workers.
Oh, my God. What a bold move on his part.
Sir.
Oh, my God. The amount of corruption in this prison. I was, like, frozen here holding the wine. I was so stressed. Oh, my God. What a Ballsy move, dude.
We sat and drank with the sun on our shoulders and felt like free men.
Aw, that's really nice.
He spent that break hunkered in the shade.
Oh, he didn't even drink the beer? He didn't want it?
Want a cold one, Andy?
Oh, he's got friends.
Gave up drinking.
Oh, he doesn't even drink. He just did it for them. Oh my God.
I think he did it just to feel normal again.
Oh, wow. I have goosebumps. That's so sweet. I don't care why he did it. I'm gonna choose to believe it's a positive reason.
Chess. And there's a game of kings.
What?
I hate it.
Me too, Morgan. I like checkers better. That's because I'm impatient and don't want to learn chess.
Why'd you do it?
Oh.
I'm innocent, Red. Just like everybody else here.
That's the mystery of this movie. Are we ever gonna know? Maybe never.
What a surprise to hear a woman singing my house, eh, Johnny?
Oh, they have a movie night.
Ah, wait.
Is it like a sexy lady? So they're like, no, don't ruin it.
Me?
Oh, these poor men. I've not seen a woman in a really long time.
What do you want?
Rita Hayworth.
What?
Oh, right. We're back to this now. I need to know why he needs Rita Hayworth. Oh, not again. I'm so surprised he didn't... I'm so grateful he put the shank down. Jesus.
Boggs spent a week in the hole.
A week? That's it? Yeah, the hole. Also solitary confinement. I think he deserved more than a week. I think, personally, Boggs should be in permanent solitary confinement. He can lose his mind in there for all I care. Oh, they like Andy, too. What are they gonna do? Because they probably like Andy. Oh, okay. All right, he's getting what he deserves. Oh, God. Oh, I still don't like this, though. Oh, God. Oh, are they gonna kill him? Yeah, because they like Andy, because he gave him all this, got him all this money and gave him a tax break.
And Boggs never walked again.
Jeez. Andy's got friends in high places.
Man likes to play chess. Let's get him some rocks.
His friend is like, wait a minute, how is... Where's the connection? How do rocks equal chess? He was so confused. His little face. The risky part is like if you sneak rocks like that into the prison, people might think you're doing it for a weapon. But it's like, no, we're just trying to play chess. It's like the dorkiest reason ever.
Well, what the hell is it then?
It's a horse apple.
Horse? Oh, is it?
Horse.
It's horse. It's not even a rock. That's so funny, man.
And of course, the most important item.
Oh, Rita Hayworth. Or Hayworth. Okay, that makes sense. A poster. That wasn't hidden very well in his room. It was very blatantly out on the bed. He's got a lot of pictures hung on his wall. Like, does he just have to tear these all down when, like, the guards do their searches? No charge. Oh, that's sweet. Oh, no. Yeah, like, I would be nervous having all those pictures on my walls. What do? Maybe you're allowed to have pictures on the walls. Maybe that's allowed. Like, where do you hide it? They're tossing it pretty thoroughly. Oh, they didn't find anything. Okay, that's good. Oh, this guy's coming in here, though.
Pleased to see you reading this.
Watch ye therefore, for ye know not when the master of the house cometh.
Oh my God, what a passage. Because it's about him showing up to toss the cells.
Can't say I approve of this.
Oh, no, don't take Rita.
But I suppose exceptions can be made.
Oh my God, they clearly favor him. The Bible stuff, he's so good at manipulating everyone a little bit. He's smart, man, Andy. He knows what he's doing.
Norton wanted to size Andy up.
Oh, really? Oh my God, he's already... What's this meeting about? Oh my God. His judgment cometh in that right soon. Wow, the fact that that's on the wall in here is crazy.
My wife made that in church group.
Great set design, honestly.
Well, perhaps we can find something more befitting a man of your education.
He is getting all kinds of special treatment. This is insane. What is a bird doing in here?
Hey, Jake, where's Brooks?
Oh, Jake still lives here. He's all grown up. Jake didn't want to leave. Oh, he's going to work with the books. Oh my God, he's been reassigned to the library.
Wouldn't be nice to have some company down here for a change.
Oh, I love this man.
That's him.
Oh no, what is it?
I was thinking about maybe setting
Andy
up some
so
kind of trust fund for my kids' education.
Ah! Andy looks so scared for a second there. Oh my God.
Why don't we have a seat and talk it over?
He's handling all the accounting for everyone. This is hysterical, man. The amount of corruption in this jail. These prison guards just don't want to go to a real bank. Oh my God, I love this, man.
How about expanding the library? Get some new books in there.
gonna ask for something, ask for a pool table.
They don't want books.
Perhaps I could write the state senate and request funds directly from them.
Would you write your letters if it makes you happy?
There you go. I hope he actually does. I don't know if he actually will, but maybe he would.
Just like Norton said, Handy got no answers.
Yeah. Look at how determined he is, though.
The following April, Andy did tax returns for half the guards at Shawshank.
These cheap motherfuckers! Oh my god! This is the wardens!
The guards on the opposing teams all remembered to bring their W-2s.
This is crazy, guys! Red is his staff! I love this! Oh, that's cool. Wow. Oh, I love this. He's just got to make sure he never messes up, though. You know, because it's possible that mistakes can happen and the IRS can come after you. And if he makes a mistake with these guys, it's really high stakes.
Please, Brooks, just calm down.
Why? What is he doing?
It's the only way they let me stay.
Oh, he's been released. He's been released and he doesn't want to leave. Oh, because he's so old. He's been here for so long. He probably doesn't know any other way of life. He doesn't want to. Oh, Brooks. Oh, and my heart breaks for him because he's been used to this.
In here, he's an important man.
Yeah, he's got a life. He's got a routine. He's got a bird. Especially because this is clearly in the earlier 1900s. Back then, there was even less resources for former felons and ex-cons. Like, now there's more resources. It's still hard for people who get out of prison to get a job and resume normal life. But at least there's groups and there's people who care. I mean, back then, there was nothing. No resources. Oh, he's setting... Oh, Jake.
I can't take care of you no more, Jake.
Ah, Jake doesn't want to leave you. Oh, maybe he will. Wait, why wouldn't... That doesn't even make sense. Did Jake just not fly out that window this whole time? Wait, Jake, you couldn't find that window this whole time? Oh, what's gonna happen to him? Oh, my heart! What is he gonna do? Where's he gonna go? Guys, I really truly don't remember any of this movie. This is like watching it for the first time.
I can't believe how fast things move on the outside.
Oh, he wrote a letter. Oh, it's been 50 years.
I try to keep up, but my hands hurt most of the time.
Oh, this poor guy.
Sometimes after work, I go to the park.
Ah! Feed the birds, tuppence a bag. Oh my God, I'm getting emotional. Oh, you just want to see Jake again. Oh, this poor man.
I've decided not to stay.
Where are you going?
I doubt they'll kick up any fuss. Not for an old crook like me.
Oh, Jesus. Okay, he's carving his name in there. Never mind. I thought, is he gonna kill himself? What? I'm like, the music paired with him standing on a chair freaked me out there for a bit. Maybe he was just carving his name in the wood and I need to calm down. Oh, no. I don't know. Oh, no. Oh! Oh, God! Oh. That is heartbreaking, man. Did they get new books? He's pissed about it, but Andy's like, books? Oh, they finally sent the books! I'm happy they put something happy right after that horrible, sad scene.
We now consider the matter closed. Please stop sending us letters.
Please stop writing! Aww.
It only took 6 years.
Yeah, the State Department didn't think you'd keep writing that long. Wow, they sent records, too. I'm sorry I have to keep blowing my nose, guys. I'm crying plus a cold does just nonstop.
Andy, do you hear that?
Oh no, did he steal the... Oh, don't lock... Oh no, he's locking him in there? That's not gonna go over well, Andy. I don't think it will. What is he doing? He's doing it so he can listen to the song? Oh no, he's gonna play it for the whole prison, isn't he? Andy, you're gonna get in trouble for that. I think this right here really proves that his intentions are good. Like, he's just trying to play some nice classical music for everybody so they can experience that beauty, you know? Because this is probably gonna get him in trouble, but he does it anyway.
And for the briefest of moments, every last man at Shawshank felt free.
Oh no, Andy, you're gonna get in trouble.
Turn that off!
Andy, you gotta stop the music. Oh no, Andy.
Andy got 2 weeks in the hole for that little stunt.
2 weeks in the hole, oh God. Oh, he's up again.
And I can honestly say I'm a changed man.
He's gonna say the same thing and get rejected again. It's interesting, you think he would just stop at yes sir and see what they ask next. Like, if it hasn't worked the last time. He's got another poster as a gift? Oh, look at this beautiful bromance that's blossomed. Oh, Marilyn this time. Oh my God.
He wrote 2 letters a week instead of 1.
And they sent more books, did they?
Appropriations Committee voted an annual payment of $500 just to shut him up.
Oh, to redo the whole library! Oh, man, he's really putting in work for this whole prison.
That was also the year Warden Norton instituted his famous Inside Out program.
What's Inside Out? I don't know what that is.
Our inmates, properly supervised, will be put to work outside these walls.
The corruption has leaked out of the prison and affected the rest of the community. Oh my God, his safe is behind, how ironic, behind the judgment quote, his corrupt money safe. Oh my God, that is the most ironic thing I've ever seen.
By the time Norton retires, I'll have made him a millionaire.
And yet he's gonna be sitting here in jail.
It's gonna lead to somebody.
Sure it is, but not to me, and certainly not to the warden.
Where would it lead to?
Randall Stevens.
Who's that?
He doesn't exist, except on paper. On the outside, I was an honest man. Straight as an arrow.
I wonder if he really never committed that murder. And so now he's just like, whatever, I'll steer into it. Oh, new fish. Who's coming in? Because the music changed. Oh, this guy in a leather jacket.
Tommy Williams came to Shawshank in 1965 on a 2-year stretch for B&E. That's breaking and entering to you.
I know. I knew what it was, Morgan.
Hey, come on, old boys. Move it like molasses.
Oh, my God.
We liked him immediately.
We liked him immediately.
Just thinking maybe trying for my high school equivalency here. You helped a couple fellas with that.
I don't waste time on losers, Tommy.
Oh,
because if we do this, we do it all the way.
Oh, he's giving him a motivational pep talk right now. Oh, he's going to teach a man how to read. I love Andy, man. Andy is, I mean, maybe my opinion will change if I found out that he did murder his wife and her lover, but I don't know if he did. I don't know. I do appreciate what he's doing in this prison, reforming people and helping them.
Must be a banker on the outside.
They're allowed to have glass bottles of soda in here? That doesn't make sense. Is it just because it's a product placement? Because it wouldn't make sense for them to have glass bottles. You could just easily break it and hurt somebody.
I was in Thomaston on a 2-3 stretch.
Oh, is he telling the real story of what happened?
Get a new cellmate in.
So I killed him. Him and this tasty he was with. He's this pricksy, this golf pro, but he married some other guy. Some hotshot banker.
He was in the cell with the guy who actually did the deed.
I have to say, that's the most amazing story I ever heard.
The warden's not gonna believe it.
You know that wouldn't matter. With Tommy's testimony, I can get a new trial.
Well, that's assuming Blatch is even still there.
Oh, God. He wants you under his thumb, dude.
If you want to indulge this fantasy, that's your business.
It's not a fantasy. He didn't do it.
I'd be just as indictable as you for laundering that money.
Oh, no. He's just under this guy's thumb. It's horrible.
Solitary, a month.
Yes, sir.
A month? Wow, I don't remember any of this. This is crazy.
Board of Education.
He passed. Oh, wait. Oh, no, he hasn't opened it yet. Oh, he doesn't want to open it. He doesn't know. I bet he passed.
The kid passed. C plus average.
Oh, he passed along the message.
Warden wants to talk.
The warden wants to talk with him? Oh, boy. What does the warden want to say? Oh God, what's happening right now? Oh God, I'm nervous they're gonna hurt him. Oh, I'm scared for him.
We got a situation here.
Oh God, he's gonna try to intimidate him into not speaking up.
If I'm gonna move on this, there can't be the least little shred of doubt.
Well, is he actually gonna do the right thing? I don't trust this warden.
Would you be willing to swear before a judge and jury?
Just give me that chance.
I'm scared that this guy's gonna get killed. Oh no. Yeah, I was gonna say, the warden's not a good guy, so, oh God, that's horrible.
We just have to put it behind us. Move on.
Ugh.
I'm done.
This is sickening. Oh yeah, he's not gonna help you anymore.
Nothing stops.
Oof. What are you gonna do, force him? Oh, no more protection, oh boy. Jesus Christ, this guy deserves to be in the worst prison in America. He deserves the worst kind of punishment.
We'll have us a little book barbecue in the yard.
A book barbecue? Like the Nazis, you're lovely.
Give him another month to think about it.
Poor Andy. This is horrible, man. This is so painful to watch. Like, this would be painful to watch even if he had committed the crime, just because, like, watching this level of corruption unfold is just awful. But especially knowing he's innocent, it's extremely painful.
You think he'll ever get out of here?
Yeah.
I'll tell you where I'd go. To Watanabe.
Where is that?
It's in Mexico.
I guess it comes down to a simple choice, really. Get busy living, or get busy dying.
I've definitely heard that before. I remember that line.
If you ever get out of here, do me a favor.
Sure, Andy.
It's so interesting that, like, they're having this high-stakes conversation as if, like, Andy's about to leave.
At the base of that wall, you'll find a rock that has no earthly business in a main hayfield. There's something buried under it I want you to have.
What is it?
You'll have to pry it up to see.
Andy, what are you about to do, my dude? You look unhinged. He's either about to escape or he's about to kill himself. I wonder if he's been carving a hole over the years behind one of those posters or something.
He asked me for a length of rope.
Oh, do they think he's gonna kill himself?
Look, if he split, I wanna get home.
I'm surprised that he still wants this guy doing all of his paperwork. Like, what if he let it back to him? Like, he doesn't like you anymore. Andy doesn't like you anymore. So wouldn't you want somebody else doing your paperwork?
Place wasn't the same without you.
Ugh. I'm sure it wasn't when you locked him away in solitary confinement for 2 months. It's so surprising the amount of blind trust that he still puts in Andy, given after everything he's put him through. Oh, God. I really hope he doesn't kill himself. Oh, there's a thunderstorm going on outside. Wow. What timing. Oh, God. He's not there. He's either dead or he left. Oh, my God. I'm, like, so nervous right now. Oh, my God. Which is it? Is he not in there?
Oh, my holy God.
What is it? Are you kidding me? Oh, the cutaway just at that time. Oh, he stole the warden's shoes. He escaped, didn't he? He didn't die. He escaped.
This is a conspiracy.
No, it's not.
And everyone's in on it. Including her.
Holy shit. And they just never, ever tore his poster sound. He's so lucky. He used a rock hammer. Holy
Andy Dufresne escaped from Shawshank prison.
He figured out that it was thin walls. That's why he asked for the Rita Hayworth poster. He didn't really care about Rita Hayworth. He wanted a poster. Oh, he switched the papers? What's the other paperwork? Did he screw the warden over? And again, I'm so surprised that the warden is just blindly trusting him after everything that the warden put him through. It doesn't make sense. Oh, he stole all the clothes. And he needed the rope for his belongings. Oh my God. Genius. Wow. He's so lucky that there happened to be a thunderstorm too. It's like the universe was on his side causing a bunch of noise so that when he sneaks out, he doesn't have to be like super quiet. Oh, he's gonna try to time it. Oh, he's gotta break the pipe? It's a shame he can't just break. Ew! It's a shame he can't just break a window, but that window was too small, even if it was breakable. Oh God. Can you even fit in that hole, dude? Oh, that was nasty.
Andy crawled to freedom through 500 yards of smelling foulness I can't even imagine.
Good thing it's raining outside. You can wash it off. Oh my God, half a mile in a sewer. Oh, you did it. It's like being baptized. Look at this. Andy, take the bag off your foot. You'll run faster. Oh my God. It really is like he's purging himself of that place. See, I remember this being the cover and I remember there being this rain scene. But for some reason in my head, I thought it was Morgan Freeman that did that, so.
Until that moment, he didn't exist.
Oh, he switched it all and he became Randall. And he switched all the paperwork to be back directed towards the warden.
I must say, I'm sorry to be losing your business.
He took all the warden's money. Karma's a bitch, warden. Yes. So he was working on that story in the warden's office. What a bold move, man. His judgment cometh, and that is right soon. Ha 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 ha. How ironic. Your time is up. Salvation lay within. Ha ha ha.
Norton had no intention of going that quietly.
Oh, or was he gonna put up a fight or kill himself? Maybe he was gonna put up a fight. I don't know. He's putting a lot of bullets in there. Really? You think you're gonna get out of this, dude? Don't kill innocent people, you prick. No, he's gonna kill himself. Oh, God. Yep. That's what I thought he would do, because he's a coward.
Sometimes it makes me sad, though.
Oh, he misses his friend. Morgan Freeman's gotta get let out. I gotta see what's under that volcanic rock thing. Yes, it's gonna be Red's time now. He's gonna get let out because we gotta see what's under that rock. Man, this feels like a little bit like how auditioning at my university used to feel. I know it's not the same thing at all. I'm not trying to be insensitive. I just mean like sitting in front of a panel of people not looking at you and just looking at paperwork.
You feel you've been rehabilitated?
Rehabilitated?
Oh, he's gonna answer differently this time.
You know, I don't have any idea what that means.
He's gonna answer honestly.
So you go on and stamp your form, Sonny, and stop wasting my time. Because to tell you the truth, I don't give a
Approved. One, the warden had to leave, and two, all he had to do was be honest. Oh my God! See, this is the stuff I remember. I remember Morgan Freeman's character a lot more. I can't believe I forgot so much of this movie. Oh my God, we're gonna get to see what's at that tree. And also, I'm just wondering, like, why Andy placed something there, or what's there? Oh, he's at the is he in the same room at the halfway house? Oh.
No way I'm gonna make it on the outside.
You gotta go find Andy. Maybe Andy put something under that rock after he escaped.
A promise I made to Andy.
Yes. Here he goes. Man, he had to hitch a ride all the way out here. I hope they'll take him back. Man's going hiking in formal wear. Oh, there it is. Wow, that is a big ass tree. It's supposed to be that? It's so subtle. I remember he said black volcanic glass, and I know that rock is kind of different colored, but still, I mean, this is hard to find, I feel like. Oh, not even buried that deep. He's looking around like, is somebody gonna see? It's gotta be documentation of some sort. What is it? Or money? What is it? Maybe a letter? A letter and money.
You remember the name of the town, don't you?
Zihuataneo. Zihuataneo. I didn't remember.
Oh. I'll keep an eye out for you.
Oh. Whoa, that shot is so beautiful with all the bugs too. It's just like, I love the perspective of that shot. Oh, he's gonna carve his name, but he's not gonna give up hope. He's gonna leave and go make a life for himself. Oh, it's beautiful. So is Red. Oh!
For the second time in my life, I'm guilty of committing a crime, parole violation. I hope the Pacific is as blue as it has been in my dreams.
Oh, that's so beautiful. Oh my God, we're actually showing this? I thought it would maybe cut off, like the end would be, he just lost his hat, he's gonna give it up. I didn't think we'd actually see them reunite. Holy I didn't think we'd actually see this. Oh, that was incredible. Absolute masterpiece from start to finish. The score was absolutely incredible. The writing was phenomenal. The acting was phenomenal. It is a novel by Stephen King. Okay. I believe that I had heard that before, but I just couldn't remember if that was true or not. Really makes me want to read the book, to be honest. I actually do like Stephen King. I don't typically read a lot by Stephen King because so much of what he does is horror, and I am a scaredy cat. Just a wonderful movie. Yeah, I definitely didn't remember so much of that, like probably 98% of that movie I had completely forgotten. I do remember that monologue from Morgan Freeman just being absolutely amazing, and I love Morgan Freeman and his work, so that stood out to me a lot. But I was really happy to revisit it from the perspective of the other character, Andy, because I had kind of forgotten his whole story, and I don't know how. This is a beautiful story about humanity and hope. Does a great job of showing how empathetic some of these characters can really be, and the worst characters in the story, the least empathetic characters who were the most corrupt, weren't even the ones who were imprisoned until the end of the book, and that was definitely really satisfying to see them get karma coming their way. That doesn't usually happen in real life, so it was nice to see it here. That subplot, that sub-story with Brooks absolutely broke my heart. It was just so beautifully well done and brought back around in such a nice way for Morgan Freeman's character, Red, to be staying in that same room, working that same job, feeling that same sense of despair that Brooks felt. And the only thing that kept him going was that curiosity and that promise he made to Andy to go look at that spot under the wall. And Andy knowing that whole time that hope was really important to have, because if you do get out of that prison and you don't have hope for anything in your life, that's when there's nothing left to keep you going anymore. So just a beautiful story of friendship and hope and humanity and I really, really enjoyed it. I'm really happy I got to revisit it here with you guys. So many moments were just so beautiful and really satisfying to watch. You don't often get a lot of satisfied karmic retribution coming at negative characters that you want to see get their comeuppance. That doesn't always happen, especially because I'm watching Game of Thrones right now. And that never happens in Game of Thrones. So I was happy that it could happen in this movie. I also really loved the score so much, mainly because the sweeping, cinematic, classical score just really knew how to carry your emotions throughout the whole movie. But also the emphasis placed on music as a whole in providing hope, the way that Andy described it, how he would use music to get him through solitary confinement and reminding people that it's important to have songs like that because it can take you to another place and another world and different experiences. And I feel the exact same way about music. That's one thing that you can't take away. And actually, one of the things that I always learned in Jewish school during Holocaust Remembrance Month is that was such a crucial part of what got people through, so many people through the concentration camp experience. And there's so many songs that were written in concentration camps that I learned as a kid. And music is just such an important, it's such an important aspect of what makes us human. Art is such an important aspect of what makes us human because it really separates us from other animals. It defines who we are as people and cultures, and it can really truly give someone something to live for and something to look forward to. So I really appreciated that inclusion in the script there. I thought that was really beautiful. And all in all, I just really enjoyed this movie and I had a great time revisiting it with y'all, and I hope you liked it as well. If you did, please give it a thumbs up because it really helps me out and it lets me know that you guys want to see more movies like this. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below and anything else you might like me to watch next, and subscribe if you want to. Till the next one, stay golden. Bye.